Most of this training will be hands-on, meaning we'll cover topics in the context of the product rather than spending time discussing system components more abstractly. The assumption here is that you already understand the value of conversational automation and know the why of chatbots and voicebots. At this point, you're more interested in the how. But some conceptual understanding is valuable, and you may want to refer back to this video as you go through the other training materials to see how your understanding has improved. This overview will briefly cover the key building blocks of automated conversations and give you some concepts to look out for as we make our way through the rest of the training. And here they are. We'll talk about endpoints, intents, slots, flows, and extensions. Endpoints are where conversations begin. Conversations can start over voice or chat channels. For voice channels, Cognigy works with major telephony and contact center applications to allow users to call a contact center and have their interaction handled solely through an automated agent. For chat channels, Cognigy connects to a variety of endpoints from a web chat on your website to SMS to Facebook Messenger and internal channels like Teams, Slack, and Skype for Business. When Cognigy receives an input from a user, it's processed by our industry-leading language AI, the natural language understanding engine that takes a freeform user input and determines the user's intention. The NLU has two components, slots and intents. Let's take slots first. Slots are categories of words that add meaning to a user utterance. For example, if a user says, "I would like to order a veggie pizza with extra cheese," or "I ordered a pizza with my account Derek at Cognigy.com an hour ago," Cognigy can identify that pizza is a food, cheese is a topping, Derek at Cognigy.com is an email, and an hour ago is a duration. Slots is a term of art in NLU discussion, but just think of it as a category. If I say pizza is a slot match for food, I mean that pizza is a match for the food category. This is important because the NLU may know that the user wants to order something, but it needs to figure out what specifically the user wants, a pizza with extra cheese. Some slot types will be domain specific, like pizza, and all the possible toppings it could have. Other slots are more conceptual or pattern-based, like dates, emails, durations, or temperatures. Dates, for example, can be expressed as tomorrow, Friday, the 23rd, or next week, and they all mean the same thing. These conceptual or pattern-based slots are built into Cognigy. The domain-specific ones may be unique to your business, whether you're an airline, an auto parts manufacturer, a pharmaceutical company, or a pizza restaurant, you have product names and business processes that are particular to you. Another ingredient, and arguably the main ingredient of NLU, is intents. An intent reflects what the user means, the main idea of their sentence. If the user says, "I would like to order a veggie pizza with extra cheese," the main idea is that they want to order a pizza. If the user is asking why their order hasn't arrived yet, the main idea is that they're making a complaint. For many, intent detection is at the heart of conversational automation. When a user calls your contact center, they ask a question and you can't predict what they might say. Detecting a user's intent, even when they're expressing themselves in ways you might not have anticipated, is key to fulfilling on a user's request. In short, if you don't understand the user's question, you can't give a good answer. Detecting the user's intent and identifying slot matches helps Cognigy guide the user to a helpful response. We respond to users in flows. You might hear terms like fulfillment or dialogue management as other ways of describing flows. At heart, the idea is, now that we know what the user wants, how do we fulfill on their request? Responding to the user may involve simply providing information. So if the user says, "Do you have vegetarian pizza?" you may just respond, "Yes, we have both vegetarian and vegan pizza options." Sometimes the response may include a follow-up question. If the user says, "What are your restaurant hours?" I might ask, "Which locations are you asking about?" Conversational automation is most powerful when it's accessing data from other systems or helping users perform actions. So if a user says, "I want to order a veggie pizza," the bot understands their intent and places an order in an order management system. If the user says, "Can you add a bottle of water to my order?" the system can find the user's order and add an additional item to it. Cognigy ships with a wide range of pre-built connectors to common enterprise systems and automation platforms. We also make it straightforward to build integrations to systems we haven't heard of yet, like a homegrown system for managing pizza orders. We call these connectors extensions. To recap, if my friend Laura wants to order a pizza, she starts off in a channel, like a web chat or a phone call. Cognigy understands her intent to place an order, and it understands the components of her order, like the type of pizza and its toppings. Cognigy then formulates an answer and adds dynamic information like the total price for her order and sends a response. In conversational automation terms, Laura starts the conversation on an endpoint. Cognigy figures out her intent and the relevant slot matches. In the flow, Cognigy manages the response and uses extensions to retrieve data from systems of record. The goal of this foundation's training is to provide a hands-on walkthrough of each of these topic areas. We won't cover extensions in the foundation course, but we'll cover endpoints, intents, slots, and flows in some detail over the coming videos. By the end of this course, you should be able to build a basic flow that can identify intents and slot matches and be published to an endpoint. I'm looking forward to sharing the Cognigy AI platform with you.